Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. It's time for our third hour. Are you ready? Because I sure as shit am. It's case number two, and we're going to crack it open. Oh, yeah. That professional look right there. That says it all. That's a man who is ready to find the truth. And the truth starts with speaking to Sophie again. Hey, Sophie, how you doing? You all good? You just kind of chilling out there? Can I get an erotica pic?
Fantastic.
Damn. I need to get over 700 for Kent.
Fantastic.
There we go. That's actually a good enough erotica shot to appease Kent when his photo challenge comes back around again sometime during case number two. There's the Shadow of North Plaza that we can go and get real quick. I think we should. Although it's going to be a long way around because we haven't unlocked any maintenance entrances yet. And also, it's still nighttime. And nighttime is a bad time for Zambos. Well, it's a bad time for me. It's a great time for Zambos. Fuck. Speaking of, well, take my queenie. Damn. That is so many maggots, and they are all going to try and kill me, aren't they? Unless I destroy them. But I really can't. Well, I can walk over them. I can walk over them, and that does the job. But it turns out that queen is really great for clearing out that elevator. If we can luck out each time, we might just find a queen there every time we try and come downstairs. Of course, later on, there'll actually be different ways to come downstairs that involve getting up on top of these shelves, and there are good weapons up there, and we can actually avoid most of these Zambos on the way out. What's in this box? What's in the box? Of course it would be a head of cabbage. But it's exactly what we need to get that one last pip of health back. Don't mind if it do. Hey, you have a hunting knife. Your hunting knife would be really helpful right about now. Cut, slice, slice, and cut. Cut and slice. You remember what I told you? Never leave home without your trusty hunting knife. Everybody runs faster with a knife. You know that. Slice, slice, and dice. Alright, so now we need to get to North Plaza, which is a ways. It's all the way up north, as you would expect. We have to go through Leisure Park to get there, which is actually a lot easier now that those psychopaths are dead. Yep, never mind. I thought he was in line for me to slice, but he was not. Slice and dice. Good thing to know, I did go ahead and save before we started the second day. So, should we die, we'll just go straight back there. But I think that in order to make sure we don't die, we're going to take some provisions with us. By which I mean that katana na 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 na, which is immediately straight upstairs. As soon as I can get there. Slice and dice. God damn it, he took more than two? Oh well. He shall survive this day. Not for a lack of trying, mind you. Trust me. I definitely sliced him a bunch. It just wasn't enough. I will take your orange juice. And I will finally drop this stupid fucking golf club. And never pick one up again. I'll take the frying pan because it's at least a decent substitute. And hello, baby. You're what I've been waiting for. All right, now I feel a little bit better about going out into North Plaza. It's not going to tell me to go through Movie Land because Movie Land doesn't let out into the other part of the mall. Slice. At least not without a little bit of a secret finding. Yep. Through Leisure Park. Yay. It certainly will be a walk in the park. We have 59 hours left until that stupid helicopter gets here and not a whole lot of time to find out the truth. And getting slapped in the face by Colin Farrell's zombie double isn't gonna help. At least I assume it was Colin Farrell. Somebody walking around in the zombie apocalypse wearing a beanie. Probably him. Nope, never mind. I thought that would be a more useful weapon than it was. Curiosity begs the question, though. Can I find the car? They're not going to be in it. But can I find it in order to, well, use it? Surely that's where the music is coming from, right? Maybe not. Slice. Mmm. Snacks. Don't mind if I do. I was a little peckish. How did you know, gang? Slice. After all the hardship that I've had dealing with these zombies so far, there is just something so satisfying about slicing them right square in half, isn't it? And yeah, basically, Harwood, you're right. Nothing like a good old OJ to be the green herb you need. We just barely made it through that one. And the fountain is broken? Yep, I made it in North Plaza. There's a shadow here. The supermarket along with a gun shop, cutlery shop, and home center. Neat. I believe we will make great use of this place, but it looks like it's also completely chock full of zombies. Like, of all the places that we've been thus far, this is one of the most zombie-laden. So we're gonna take the high road, and you'll take the low road. Oh, they do? Hey, Noble, welcome. Glad you could join us. I didn't realize they respond. That's super annoying. Well, I say super annoying, but it may be really great because, you know, experience points. Assuming that we get that same psychopath bonus every time we kill them. That may not be the worst deal in the world, you know? Assuming we always walk outside with a handgun. Which could happen. After all, there's one right there. Let's go ahead and swap it out for the knife. I assume we're gonna end up back out in Leisure Park at some point. So it might not be a bad idea just to have it. Speaking of, let me save my katana for a slightly more dangerous situation. And instead we'll switch back to the frying pan. I just skipped around a whole bunch of the mall. That's where the shadow is. Then before we go and take on that quest, let me... Oh, no. Oh, no. Get horribly eaten by zombies. Stop it. Get off of me. No. Bastards. Yeah. We can ride that crowd all day, son. Let me try and make it over to the save point. There we go. I'll take the high road and ye take the low road and I'll get to the bathroom before ye. I wish I could say that's not fun every time, but it's fun every time. Every single time, smacking him in the face with the fucking frying pan. It's the best. It's okay, Queen. As you saw earlier, even I am not immune from computer problems. In fact, especially I am not immune from computer problems. So it happens to the best of us. What did it change clothes? Oh, he took off his glasses. No, I want my glasses. I can't be seen without my glasses. I did really love it when, oh God. Oh no, dear. Oh dear, geez. I loved it right in the beginning of the game when Frank West pulls off his actual black sunglasses and it reveals the red sunglasses underneath. Probably one of my favorite moments so far. Oh, no. Bad zombie, bad. A zombie came around the corner. They have found me. They have found me in the bathroom, you guys. They must have heard me taking a tinkle. Oh, Frank, this is why you have plenty of fiber. So that way you don't blow up the goddamn toilet. Oh, boy. Jump. There we go. We made it. And, of course, the katana is dead. Fuck. All right. The store we need to go into is right across the way. There is a cutlery shop somewhere in this place.
Help me.
Oh,
help me.
But there's a gentleman here and a nail gun. Hello, nail gun. Hey, zombie, you wanna get nailed? Come here, let me get my drill and I'll screw you too. Hello, David, how you doing? How you feeling? You holding up just fine? You certainly got enough food for it. I wonder if I can break through there. You need to get up, sir. I really need you to be able to help me, and right now you're just being a hindrance. David, I'm eating all of your food unless you come with me. Like, literally, I'm gonna eat all of your food, and I know that it's gonna be a deal breaker for you, so you might wanna come along. Really? Really? There you go. Do I look like a goddamn zombie to you? I'm killing all the zombies. Do zombies kill each other with frying pans? Queen says use the traffic cone. I think I will use the traffic cone. Oh, look! You don't suppose that's where Plants vs. Zombies got it, do you? Because they do have a cone head zombie and a bucket head zombie, both of which you can do in this game. Are you gonna come? Oh, what's wrong with your leg? I went to get some food at the market, but this crazy guy tried to kill me. Okay. He said he was gonna punish you for shoplifting. Well now. And I just accidentally used the orange juice. Son of a bitch!
Son of a bitch.
I agree, David. I guess handgun it is. I literally have no other weapons left, but it's surprisingly effective. Excellent, he joined me. Let's go, buddy. We're gonna make it out together through the zombie hordes. You think it is safe? It is really not. But we're gonna make it together, cause teamwork. Oh. Gallop on my shoulders! I am your mighty steed, David! We are so close to the exit already. And I have to make it all the way across. Oh boy. You know what? Not worth it. Not worth it to go back and try and save. We're just gonna keep on going with David and pray against all hope that we're able to make it through. Oh boy. Come on, zombies. You see nothing. We are just like you. Couple of shambling dudes trying to make it. Holy shit. I can't believe this might actually work. We might actually just be able to quickly shuffle through every single zombie. Where are we going? Not Chris Lips Home Salon. We're going through Leisure fucking Park. God. Ugh. Of all the things you can make us do, it is the most annoying. Leisure Park.
I can't believe this.
What can't you believe? That we're having to deal with the zombies? Yes, I know. It's the worst, isn't it? Just come with me if you want to live. I am massaging his side because that's the side that's hurt. And you know what? We are nothing if not a gracious host. So every shoulder ride comes with a free massage. That's the Tim guarantee. Okay, I see them way over there. The good news is I still have a gun. And I have that nail gun too. Which I know the nail gun doesn't do as much damage, but it certainly helps. And I'm pretty sure this is our easiest entrance here, so might as well go ahead and just... God, if I leave him here, he's gonna die. He's gonna die so bad because he has no way of protecting himself, and he can't run. So let's just go ahead and get him back to the safe point. We'll pick up another katana, some more fucking orange juice, and everything will be hunky-dory. Don't mind me, zombies, just coming through. Everything's fine here. Jesus Christ, this is nerve-wracking. There's the same point over there. I don't know that we have access to this tunnel yet. You know what? He's got his hand right square in my face, so I have no idea how Frank knows where he's running. Okay, Dan? There's a bunch of things about this arrangement that are a little weird. Bye, Hawk. Thank you so much, man. I really appreciate you saying that. We are live every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, so please, come on back. On Tuesdays, we play chat interactive games where you can play too, like Quiplash and Drawful and Jackbox stuff. All right. So, can we open this door? Fuck! Of course I need the maintenance tunnel key to open it. Okay, we saved, so that's a good thing. David's still alive. He's gonna stay alive until we can get him back to the post now, because well, even if he dies, we can die and start back over again. Yeah, sorry, Harwood. Unfortunately, none of those are here again tonight. I am gonna have to make some serious decisions here because I do not like not having mods. That's kind of really important. And I know that people are people, and sometimes schedules don't mesh. So I need to have enough of a safety net that if one person can't make it, two people can be here. If two people can't make it, at least some goddamn body's gonna have the sword. be able to wield that banhammer when I need it. Even if it's fucking Dan. Oh, you know what? Oh god, that hurt. You know what? Oh god damn it, that hurt too. I guess the solid shelving will work. But what I really wanted was this mannequin. Because it turns out mannequins are actually really good at crowd clearing too. They may not do a whole lot of damage, but they clear like a son of a bitch. The torso actually has a good bit of stamina to it. And we can just knock people the fuck out. David, 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 I really need you to move it, buddy. Excellent. Excuse me, pardon me. You don't belong here. You don't belong here, Mr. Zambo. I'm beating you with my fists. I am so sick and fucking tired of these motherfucking zombies in this motherfucking mall. Well, you know what, Queen? Maybe Davey shouldn't be in my goddamn way. No, I only have 4. Oh, right. He can't follow me. Not without being incredibly slow. Can we give him a boost? Use the boost to get up. I believe in you, David. Excellent. I knew he could make it. Oh, goddammit.
Follow me! Come on! Follow me! Come on!
Wow. That was an extremely quick climb for somebody with an injured leg. Are you sure you're not giving me the business? David Bailey, 44. Yeah, he was a little bit out of the way to try and get you. Thank you for at least acknowledging that fact. Asshole.
Yeah.
Oh, sweet. We got our throw distance raised. Or throw strength and distance, I guess. To 125%. Sweet. Eventually, we'll just be hucking shit left and right. We still can't get through this area. Do I have any other side quests that we can do? Japanese tourist is about to run out. And Japanese tourist is right next to out of control. And out of control is really tough. And I've only got about 3 hours with which to do another mission. I think that should be about enough time, but it's going to be cutting it close, dude. Like, super duper close. And I really wish I had that alternate entrance to this place unlocked. But as of right now, I'm just beating people with a mannequin torso. Which, while amusing, makes a really great and satisfying sound. It's not really working out as well as I had hoped. Oh no, we're taken to the ground. Why? Why, oh why, were we taken to the ground there? I thought I was wiggling and jiggling, but I guess I wasn't wiggling and jiggling hard enough. All right, let's go. Surely, that zombie in the elevator won't try and eat us as we're going down. That's kind of the zombie code, right? Once the elevator's moving, it's all safe. Oh, you've got a queen in you. I recognize your queen, Shimmy Sham. Yep. All right. Break? No. Every time you hit a zombie with this thing, there's a chance that it could break. And once it breaks, that's when you get all the pieces parts that you can actually use. There we go. Give me that torso. Yeah, baby. Give me that torso. I'm going to beat things with it. It's choosing to wiggle and jiggle it all, Dan. Some people choose not to jiggle, but personally, I will wiggle. I will take it upon myself to wiggle any opportunity that I can. Wiggle and also jiggle. Because that, my friends, is the American way. Can we not make a salient point without hitting our microphone, please? Good job, Tim. Get away, get away, go away. Stupid Zambos. Yep. A little bit of crowd surfing action there for you, instead of trying to beat our way through with a torso. Which, while, you know, we could do it. Nicorette wouldn't help that. I will take the custard pie, though. Nom, 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 nom. And the orange juice. And that ever-important katana. Now, the bad thing is, once you come over this ledge, you can't get back up again. It just kind of glitches out on it for you. So the only way to go is, in fact, down. Which leaves you just, like, momentarily vulnerable, and then you can move on. I don't really have anything else for zombie beating other than the torso and the sword. And I kind of want to save the sword for when we get over to Out of Control, because that bitch is going to be tough. Okay. I guess we can take the electric guitar. Well. How about the acoustic? Come on! Much better. Much better. Come on! Oh, Hanna-Barbera cartoons. I am really old. I am really super duper old. Come on! And I am also gonna have another one of my sour straws. This one, I believe, is straight cherry. And so it'll be extra sour. Where you at, boy? I need some company. And also your car. I see you. Suddenly the hunters have become the hunted. It looks like they're caught on a tree already. Well, not even a tree, a fucking lamppost. Dumbasses.
Yep.
Okay, so if I can get close enough to take out even, well, I definitely want to take out the gunner first. He is definitely the most dangerous in this situation. And it looks like he might not be able to get the drop on us from here. So let me go ahead and, well, make sure that we're safe long enough to kill these guys. Slice. 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 Julianne. Yep. Okay, and now we'll take this opportunity to pop off a couple rounds in his dome. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Shit. I see you getting closer, zombies. I see you getting closer. Come on! Let's see how you like light rock. Oh, you don't like that? How about heavy rock? That is not as effective as I was hoping it would be. We gotta take out the katana and do some serious work here, unfortunately. Queen, I picked it up literally right before we stepped out into Leisure Park. It was in the music store. Slice, and last one. Yep, I figured that would be the last hit. Oh no, they're free. Oh no, they're free. You guys, they're actually free. They're free from their prison. And they're coming from my butt. This is not good. I'm not gonna be able to trap them behind that lamppost again because of the way that car turns. Okay, we need to get somewhere safe and drink orange juice. Oh boy. This is not gonna be somewhere safe. Unfortunately, get the gun out. Oh, nice. Right into the fucking tree. And back up. And back at it. Like, oh my god, my crotch. Get the fuck off me. Yep. I've already hit that the guy in the gutter seat about 6 or 7 times. So get off my dick. So if I can just nail him a couple more. One. Oh god, that was that zombie. Okay. Fine. Fine, assholes. We're gonna have to change the location of this, or, even better, take McQueen! Nice. Nice. Fucking nice. Tim! And, oh god, oh, the fucking bugs. I forgot about the slugs. Doop. And one more should do it. Oh, really? That should have been 10. Nope. There we go, now he's dead. And quickly. Now we can unleash hell, boys. Hello, Dolly. I just literally put the barrel up to the side of his face and ruined his day. Honestly, we really don't need the Jeep. We're going right there. And I might just try and carry this gun with me all the way to fucking Out of Control. How great would that be? Well, you guys may not know what's there, but I do. And what's there is not fun. I know I keep saying that, but a weapon like this would be really great for dealing with the psychopath we're gonna find there. Because he is probably one of the biggest assholes in the game. But his rewards are super sweet. Like these candy straws. So it's kind of worth it. Get off me! You made me drop my machine gun. Asshole. I need that. For killing. Alright. So we finally made it to the amusement park section. Turns out this mall has a huge roller coaster in it.
Yay!
And I am in Wonderland Plaza. And you made me drop my machine gun! God damn it, Otis! Space Rider roller coaster is in this area. And we can actually use that to kill some zombies on if we wanted to. I don't think I will. But if we really wanted to, we could take a ride on the wild side. Although, I'm looking at image in the monitor. That thing is at less than 3 hours. We need to finish this up now. Or else we're not going to be able to make it back to image in the monitor before it goes off. Okay, what? Oh, okay, I need to stop the roller coaster. I was like, what do I need to do here? You know what? The Japanese tourist may end up having to... Oh my god, here he is! It's the goddamn clown! And this clown ain't fucking around. Now he wields dual chainsaws! They are noble. Those chainsaws are fucking great, especially once you get the perks and books required to actually, like, keep them from getting destroyed in about 3 hits, you know? I know, you were hoping to, what, kill them with laughter? Turns out the zombies just kill them with eating. And yeah, basically, he's a big old giant murder clown. Oh, God. This guy is literally what nightmares are made of. Like, if little boys are made of snips and snails and puppy dog tails, this is what nightmares are made of. Oh, God, that hurt. And I lost my fucking... Okay. You and me are gonna have to fight this out, clown. I do not approve of your shenanigans. Crap. Speaking of shenanigans, he fell down. He fell down, go boom. And he's suddenly out of the area. Where'd you go? Where'd you go, clown? Not messing around no more. Hey. Damn, I gotta wait for him to actually, like, become vulnerable again every time I hit him. I can hit him for a decent amount with this gun when I actually get the chance to maybe plug more than one round into his face. But unfortunately, that opportunity is fewer and farther between than I would like. God damn it. Yeah, no, this is what Pennywise nightmare's about. This is what goes bump in his night. And just a few more hits. Yes! That murder gun. Oh god, he fell onto his own chainsaws. Oh, please don't throw up in that horse head, Frank. That thing's hard to clean. Oh god. That tickled, I guess. We obtained the ID card and a small chainsaw. I'm gonna hold on to that for a while. Jesus. So now we should be able to stop the roller coaster, right? Now that the psychopath, he's like, please just stop the thing. And there was a survivor trapped. A security guard, it looks like. Oh god, he's gonna be so fucking sick. Sir? Oh god, sir! You all are gonna have to get in an orderly line, or else we're just gonna have to clear the line. George, Greg, I almost called you George. Greg, come with me if you want to live. Ooh, I got two small chainsaws. Sweet. Hey, Greg, why don't you take? Where are you going, Greg? No, Greg, you're doing exactly the opposite thing that you need to do. He's running off like a scared little bitch. He's gonna end up cornering himself in a crowd of zombies, kind of like I am, trying to clear the way for wherever the hell it is he's going. I'm gonna need to abandon your ass here in a minute, so you might want to go ahead and just move it, sister. Oh God! Oh no! That's my dick! That's my dick and crotch! Oh, hey! You got a PP! Oh, you son of a bitch! How did I miss the PP opportunity? Of course I missed it. Because that Zambo's head was square in the way, huh? Fine. Come on, Greg. Where are you taking me? You're taking me somewhere. Yes, I did. I used a giant Gatling gun. Oh, no. This is bad. Wow. And there goes the PP opportunity. Thank you, handgun.
Yep.
Thank you, handgun.
Yep.
Excellent. How you feeling, Greg? Feeling good? Feeling snazzy? Let's go. Let's go, Beefy. Oh God, that was a coke-fueled burp right there. Oh boy! For a second there, I could have sworn that was gonna be my doom. I am happy that it wasn't, but it was way too goddamn close. I want to use these mini fucking chainsaws, but I feel like it's not the time for that. I feel like they're not at their maximum effectiveness. Ooh, groovy baby. Yeah, Greg definitely wants my PP. Or maybe he wants to give me his PP. I don't really know. I haven't figured that out yet. Fine. Mini chainsaw. Just a couple of hits there. The bad part is that mini chainsaw degrades so goddamn quickly that you really can only get off like 3 or 4 hits with it before it starts to blink on you. And nobody likes a blinky chainsaw. Oh yeah, there's your PP. Nice. 2,444 fucking PP. That's a lot of bonus experience, baby. Ooh, is that a save point? Is that a save point I see before me? You bet your sweet ass it is. Shut up, Greg. I have to pee really badly. Are you gonna stop a man with a horse head from using the bathroom? No, I didn't fucking think so. Excellent. Greg, I appreciate you waiting for me, bud, but you really need to get better about the self-defense stuff, and we need to move with you. Excellent. Where'd you go, Greg? Greg. Oh, you're going in here. Hi, where are we going? In the ladies' room. Ooh, secret rendezvous in the ladies' room, Greg. What are we doing here? What? Just head through here, and we're already at Paradise Plaza. What? Head through where? There's no door. The fuck are you talking about? Is it on the floor? Is it in the sink? No, that makes us take off our glasses. And as we've already stated, can't be seen without our glasses. Is it a vent in the ceiling? It is a vent in the ceiling. Awesome. Vent in the ceiling. See, I thought for a minute there we were supposed to be Mirror Man, but no, not this time. Mirror Master, excuse me. Oh, Gregory. Take this gun. You're gonna need it. Yes. Take this guitar. It helps you better than the gun. And you wouldn't happen to have a key to the maintenance tunnels, would you? No? Because that would be useful. You know what? Let's go back for the man in the monitor. Because I have a feeling that by the time we make it back with Greg, to turn him in, it's gonna be about that time, folks. Yep. Oh boy, that's my death. That is my untimely death. God damn it. The good news is we literally just saved back in the men's room before we went into the ladies' room to figure out what the fuck we're supposed to do. So, we're good, but that could have been potentially very annoying.
Anyone there?
Greg? Anyone there? Greg? Good man, Charlie Brown. The good news is now we know where we're going. We don't have to sit there and search for it. And we're back. I think I've actually died 4 times tonight. Only 4. Which is actually pretty decent. I know people who have made it through in zero death runs, but they've played the game before. This is actually my first time playing it for an extended period. And unfortunately, no, you cannot move around while you're aiming a gun. So, you're just kind of left to your own devices there. Kick through the window. Hey, I found a shortcut. I made a shortcut of my own, Greg. How do you like that? Oh yeah, I forgot. I didn't actually even give him any weapons. Greg! I guess being a security guard, you probably don't want to break any rules. Like, going through the glass. Oh, I guess I can give him only one weapon at a time, huh? Fine, Kabong. Let's go.
Follow me.
I guess before I even try and make it all the way back to the fucking... Oh, boy. Before I even try and make it back to the safe house, I need to get some health. Desperately and badly need to get some health. So let's try and make that magic happen before we keel over. Where you at, Greg? I'm at Colombian Roastmasters. Thank you, Kisty. This has been our outfit for basically the entire run. As Queen will unfortunately be able to attest to, that is a true statement. Oh no. We picked up the handgun again. Wait a minute. I see a guide here. Put down the goddamned handgun, Frank. Recommended beverage, Zombait. This juice... particular aroma attracts certain unsavory characters. Interesting. So it showed me a couple of different colors there. And it tells me a little bit about their effects, but not any more information than we absolutely desperately need, right? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put that down. And katana time! Yeah, buddy! Sweet! Now I feel much better about our chances to be able to make it back to the safe house. Come on, Zambos! Who's feeling lucky? I'm gonna put down that 8-shot handgun and. Come on, Gregory! We're gonna rumble through the jungle. Where you at? Oh, he's probably way upstairs, isn't he? Oh, that's my crotch. That's my very deadly crotch. I'm sorry, Zambos. I don't mean to just flaunt it in front of you like that. I know it's an irresistible target, but you can't just be going along biting people in the dick. That's just rude. Okay, where are we going? Where are we going? Where are we going? Why are we going there? Right the fuck here. The guide arrow is taking us all the way back to Image of the Monitor. So let's go. Good news is we were basically dead on the right way. If you'll pardon the expression. Hey, you have a queen in you. I recognize that shimmy shuffle. And that's gonna be extremely helpful here shortly. You know what? I want to try and take a picture of the queen killing process. Like, when a queen goes to explode all the heads of all the Zambos that are around. I want to take a couple pictures of that. I feel like that might net me some good points. Would you agree?
Yep!
Come on, Gregory. I believe in your abilities to make it through mildly unscathed.
Follow me. Come on.
Really? I gave you a fucking guitar, and you can't soothe the savage beast with music? Really? Otis? Not the time, dude. What? I'm glad I'm still alive, too. We're doing pretty decently, actually. Jesse's really worried. You ought to stop by the security room to see her. Fine. Fine. You mean that room that we're literally right outside of? Do I need to give you a GPS chip on me so that way you know that I am right the fuck here? Waiting on you, dude. Waiting on you, Gregory. Thank you. And he's only down to half health. You're going to be able to heal that back in no time. Going down. And we got a decent amount of larvae there, too.
Jesus.
Wow. That is one killer picture.
Holy shit.
I am now so fucking glad I did that. And we got a level up too. Nice. Stock up. So now what, 7? Yep, that is 7 items that we can now hold. I mean, yeah, I'd say it was worth taking the pictures. I'd say it was totally worth taking the pictures of them.
Come on.
So we've done that now, what, 3 or 4 times? And could have gotten a shit ton more experience? Excellent. Good job, Greg. Oh, and he knows Otis. Excellent. I'm glad that we were able to reunite some friends. A 30 fucking thousand PP bonus as well, too. Holy hot damn. Am I interrupting something here? Frank's throwing out his shoulder through so many zombie slayings. What? What do you see?
That can't be good. What's going on anyway?
I mean, I would really like if you would tell me.
Someone called the professor and told him to come to this mall.
Check the
right.
Did you?
Oh yeah, because he said he was summoned. Oh my God.
Caller, this guy here.
He's being dragged out of his bookstore.
The zombies, don't they?
There. We need to go and rescue the professor.
And if he gets away with Dr.
Bad news, everyone. I'm being drug away. Hmm. Case 2-1, finished. Case 2-2, engage! We shall, in fact, override our save data. Thank you kindly. And it's time to rescue the professor. In a very short window, too. Wow. We'll be able to finish up photo challenge here in a little bit. Those Japanese tourists are probably gonna end up biting dust, and I'm sorry, but, excuse me. You can't save them all. Hell, you can barely save half of them, really. Like, Frank's doing pretty damn good, as is. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. The shower head's one of my favorite little joke weapons. It is an instant kill. I mean, that is not a joke weapon in that it doesn't hurt, because it definitely hurts. But it's a joke weapon in that it turns them into a blood shower until they die. And then I can do it again on the next mostly unwilling victim.
Yep.
As soon as I can get back the goddamn shower head. Yay, shower head. Boop. Now you're a shower head. Oh, look, there was a PP point on the fucking air duct. I had no idea. Huh. Yep. No, go downstairs. Oh, mama. That was gonna be real bad. Like, real bad. I will take this lead pipe, however. I'm going to rescue the fucking... Shutter leading to the main entrance is here. Guy dragging the old man opened it. At any rate, you can get into the entrance plaza through this place now.
Hello?
Crap. Crappity crap. Get off me. Stupid Zambos. Yeah. You would think that Frank would be rubbing his neck because of all the zombie bites that we've gotten so far. But I guess zombiness doesn't transfer that way here. Oh no! You were coming up on me super quick, dude. You can't scare a man like that. Yeah, they're not a part of the main story, unfortunately. So, because of how long it took me to get over to the clown, and how long it would have taken me to deal with their situation, I guess I probably could have. You know what they do have, Queen? They had sniper rifles. It's a Japanese dad and son. and they have sniper rifles, which could be very useful if I was taking down the clown that way. But, hello! We have another sniper rifle available to us here in just a minute. A more powerful one. And I still have the clown's weapons with which to kill him. Also, that's racist. Assuming that the Japanese people would have katana. No. Oh my god! Carlito's using the professor as bait.
It's the professor.
Guys. Did you shoot him? Because I didn't shoot him. Did you shoot him? I didn't shoot him. Who shot him?
We don't do something. The professor's gonna end up zombie.
Oh, it was probably Carlito. I don't know. Carlito's just a dick.
You just worry about staying alive. Got it?
Carlito. Fine. If you want to try and take care of him, be my guest. I guess we're both just going to fight him again. We're in the entrance plaza, which unfortunately, as we now know, is not exactly laden with weapons. You dig? Oh god, Carlito's got the sniper rifle. That hurts. That hurts my face and butt. And of course, I am without any long-range weapon whatsoever. Fuck. So I have to make the approach on foot, getting shot by a 50 caliber sniper rifle. I definitely brought a sword to a gunfight. I'm trying, Kisty, but unfortunately Frank only moves so fast. And here he comes, here he comes, here he comes, here he comes, here he comes to get his shit. They literally plugged me in the chest for 2 fucking hearts. Like, I can't. Alright, if you can stop him from doing that, Brad, that would be great. Brad, if you could stop him from, oh, that's gonna hurt. Wait, am I supposed to be going after Barnaby? I think I might be supposed to be going after Barnaby and saving his ass. In which case, I've got just the weapon for that. He says, completely missing the first shot. Just the weapon! Ah, ha, 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 ha. What? What? How? What? What? How? I'm guessing maybe Brad died, or maybe the professor died? Oh no, the scoop chance lost was only the Japanese family dying. Yeah. Damn. I kind of gave up there thinking that it was saying that the story was over. Fuck. Oh well, it's fine. We can get back there quickly. We know where we're going. No, I think scoops are the side missions. Like the Japanese tourists. But one thing we can do now is we can actually go ahead and take the chance to go grab another katana. And yeah. You are not wrong there, Kisty. At least a gun. Something that can let us be able to help Brad a little bit. Oh god. I almost didn't make it over him. Ugh, and now he's gonna complain about how I never listen to him, and why do you always interrupt me, and it's rude, and you're an asshole, and you never look at me during anymore, and yada, 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 yada. You know, the gun shop would be a really great place if I had access to the gun shop yet, but I don't. So, unfortunately, god damn it! Get the fuck off me, zombies! Seriously! There! You happy now? You are in twain. You are actually cleaved. And what? Otis! God damn it! I don't give a fuck about your feelings right now, dude! I'm kind of in the middle of the zombie apocalypse! You haven't noticed here? Shit gets a little rough. I really want Frank to lose it on Otis at some point. He just answers it, fucking what? Otis is like, dude, calm down. You need to take some Zombrex. You're starting to have some aggression issues. Frank's like, what Zombrex? That's in the next game, you asshole. I guess after taking a couple of bites to the dick, Frank needs a second, huh? Oh, you're doing a shimmy sham. No, you're not doing a shimmy sham. Damn. Heh. I guess I really shouldn't be wasting the katana I just spent all that time trying to get, huh? No good magazines there, unfortunately. We just have to... See, I think at this point, Frank is trying to pretend that he's a zombie, you know? So that way, maybe they won't notice him. Maybe he'll just blend right in. I know, right, Queen? Like, I would totally love this place. Ow. Oh, he made me get down. That's right. I forgot. Unfortunately. Ooh, that one was a shower. Unfortunately, we had absolutely zero opportunity to be able to pick up a weapon, a long range weapon. So Carlito still kind of has a drop on us with that snipper rifle. But so long as he can keep missing like that, we should be okay. Two people hold up in one of the shoe stores in Wonderland Plaza. Guy and a girl. Must be a couple. Looks like something's wrong, though. Fine. We'll rescue them in a fucking minute. I gotta get the professor out first. Oh, boy. Maybe I should... Maybe. Yeah. Fuck it. All the zombies die today. And just to make sure that we don't waste it all. Ow. Oh, he's got a zombie hand. I was like, what are you going for, Zombo? The hand. Yep. Yep. One more. Use it till you lose it. There we go. And now we can use the 2x4. Like Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Ho! Sorry, Tim is incredibly old and so has references that date way the fuck back. Take it! And I still can't rescue Barnaby. I killed all the zombies that were around him. Still can't rescue him. Okay, we're gonna think about it for a minute while we have a snack. Pick up this baseball bat and I guess maybe run around and try and take out Carlito from the back. Carlito does seem like the kind of man who would be vulnerable from the rear, if you know what I mean. We could take some benches. There's the entrance that started this whole fucking mess. The zombies were just outside the mall until that bitch decided to let him in. And we got the jump on him. Oh no, he's going to the Bugs BB. And literally just cutscene. And that's what happens when you lose the case. I don't know how we lost it. But this is what happens when you lose the case. The truth has vanished into darkness. And you'll never know what happened in this mall. You can load the game to be where you were. You can return the game and continue playing the 72 hours. Or you can save and quit and start the game over. Of course, we're going to load because, as we previously discovered, we're literally, like, right there. So we're good. But yeah, kind of a dick move by the game. I could have swore that we were still in range for them, you know? That's really rather arbitrary. Hey! How's everybody doing? I know it's a crowded elevator, you guys. You got room for one more? Let's make some room here, people. Shove on in. We'll get friendly. Nobody bites around here, right? Well, we discovered that it's not Barnaby that we're supposed to be going for. I don't know what we're supposed to be going for, whether it's just Carlito. But saving Barnaby is not the primary objective there. Yes, yes, I know. The shuttered entrance plaza is open. Blah, 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 blah. Who'd have thunk an entrance would be open? And there it is.
Yep.
Just kicked him right square out of the way. Otis, you were literally about to get interrupted again, dude. So I don't think now is a good time for you to be calling me on the phone.
Don't be daydreaming out here.
All right, I'm actually gonna pay attention this time, kind of, sort of, maybe, a little bit, and see if we can figure out exactly what the hell is going on here. And what I'm supposed to do. Carlito. So I guess our objective really is to take out Carlito in this epic rematch of the century. We have to make it up the stairs quick, and I'm assuming that he's talking to whoever's in the locket, whatever that panchama means. And basically what I need to do here is smash and run. We're gonna go ahead and pull out the chainsaw. Wow, good job, Brad. Just that, yeah, that wall is so super intimidated right now. Fired a warning shot right square into it, buddy. Oh, guess what I have? A fucking dodge maneuver that I completely forgot about. Oh, God. The good news is he doesn't get hurt near as bad as we do. Really? Really? He fires two shots with it? What a bag of dicks. And we're close enough. We're close enough. We're close enough for melee damage. Ah, come here. Come here, you son of a bitch. Oh, no, you don't. You think you're gonna... Oh, God damn it. He got away. He got away. But I nailed him a couple of times. And that's what matters. We're gonna nail Carlito even harder. Next time I get to you. I want your booty. I want your booty, Carlito. So that I can nail it. Oh, yeah. Oh, you son of a bitch. God, oh no! No, 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 no. Crap. Crap. And me and the one store in this place that would not have any fucking weapons. Yes, it gives me a ranged attack, but a ranged attack that sucks balls. Ah, God fucking Jesus shit, cunting, damn it, Christ. Stop it! Really? 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 About to say, don't be a dick game. This game is a total dick, so I don't know why I'm expecting anything else. And we're dead. And we're fucking dead. Fuck. Yes, hitting him with the chainsaw does give me a stun. I can throw the chainsaw at him and pick it back up again. That is something that I can definitely do. I'm wondering if I shouldn't take more fucking healing items. Let me grab a coffee creamer. But, I mean, I tried to find a pistol. There's just... There aren't any pistols between here and fucking the boss fight, you know? I think I'm gonna try again to find a pistol. God damn it. And it would also help if we can actually get there with full health, you know? That would be a nice thing. I had two jugs of orange juice, Kisty. He shot straight through both of them. Because that fucking sniper rifle is like 50 caliber. It should create a crater inside of our chest the size of a basketball. But instead, it just takes away two health, and I'm kind of glad for that. Oh, no! No! I would rather be stabbed with a knife. Okay. You done? You done? Excellent. Alright, so I need to maybe try and find a cop zombie? A cop zombie would have either a gun or a nightstick. Here's a cop zombie, but it has a nightstick, of course. Definitely not the thing that we need. I don't see any more in the immediate vicinity. Yep. Don't mind me. Coming through. Unfortunately, we got another kid's clothing store. Yay! I found my original Ratman shirt. Yay! Okay, and jumping over. Damn it. I see absolutely nothing in the way of firearms or any zombos carrying firearms. I mean, we can go upstairs and grab another katana. And also use some more slash get some more orange juice. Hit! Climb those zombies! Climb those zombies, Frank! There we go. Because I have a feeling that's going to be a super help. In fact, I might even go ahead and just blend two of these orange juices into a nectar. I don't really know what the benefits of a nectar are versus just straight orange juice, but I imagine that there are some. Poop. I love how it just pops out like a fucking grenade. And jump over the railing for the other katana. No. Don't mind if I do. Alright. So we have four great melee weapons right now. And three containers of healing. All of which should get me more than full health no matter how much he fucks us up. I need to get back over to Entrance Plaza. You have a queen in you. Which I would have to give up something in order to get. Wait a minute. You have a gun? No, you have a fucking nightstick. God damn it. And we lost the scoop chance for the Japanese couple. But we knew that was going to happen. Okay, what you got, Otis? Two people hold up in the shoe stores in Wonderland Plaza. Yes, yes, we know. Wait. They're holed up here. They're holed up literally right here. So can I just grab them real quick? Ah, goddammit. Oh wait, no, we're not in Wonderland Plaza. I'm dumb. I'm still learning this mall. We're in Paradise Plaza. Wonderland Plaza was over here back with the roller coaster. There we go. Alright, so let's go ahead and go back to rescue the professor. He definitely needs the help. Brad needs some cover, and we need a pistol. But unfortunately, we can't get any of those things right now. So the only thing that we can hope for is a chance to go and fuck his world up. If only we had, like, just any sort of run faster skill. Yes, I know, Carlito. You're very angry at us right now. But it's okay, bro. It's gonna be alright. I just need you to not shoot me. Whatever you do, don't shoot me. I'm only here to chainsaw you to death. Excellent. I need you to keep your focus on Brad, Carlito. Also, I could really use Brad getting him to come this way a little bit more. Ugh, god damn it. It's basically just dodge straight into the wall. Because at this point, all we're really going to do is keep him kind of bouncing back and forth in this place where he never really gets exposed, you know? Let me go ahead and use one of the OJs. Yeah, I hate having to use fucking healing already. Also, he really should have a reload mechanic. What? Okay, he didn't hit me for any damage. And I was like, how the fuck did he shoot over his shoulder? Excellent. No. Stay. No. Aha! That's my opportunity. And there's a grenade. God damn it. Shoot him. Shoot him, Brad. Shoot him now. God damn it, you're the worst. You're the worst partner ever, Brad. Alright, alright. We will have a ranged attack with this. But it won't be a fucking good one. Oh my god. Damn it. Are you serious? Brad's gonna fucking die, dude. If we don't do something right now, Brad's gonna fucking die. And then the mission's done. Like, this is how it happens. I need to be able to get over around. I need to be able to get over and around. Brad, you keep his focus. I'm gonna run around. Oh my god. This is going to end so poorly for at least one of the people in this room. If not two or three. Fuck! Well, we're gonna use the OJ. That's all the nectar I have. Fuck me! Are you serious? And Brad is so super almost dead because I can't get anywhere near close to Carlito. Like, what the fuck even is this shit? And there was a free queen sitting right there. God damn it. And he's gonna shoot Brad right in the back of his fucking head. Brad's dead. Brad is very, very, very dead. Unless... I am going to shit a fucking brick. Are you kidding me right now? Are you fucking kidding me right now? All the preparation that I did, all the fucking gathering of shit, and he still fucks me in the ass. Carlito, I am going to murder you. And when I do, you're going to stay murdered. Do you understand me? He doesn't understand me because he only speaks Spanish. God damn it. I guess he's gonna have to speak language. Zombies, you're really catching me at a bad time right now. Eat the meat, leave me alone. Yeah. Frank is not in the mood to fuck about, as they say. Cause Otis is gonna be bothering me here in about 2 seconds. I know it. I know he's gonna call. I know he's gonna call. There it fucking is. I don't give a shit about the entrance plaza. I know it's open. I can see it's open. I noticed, but that thing is so fucking hard to actually hit with. Shut up, Otis. And now let's try this for a third time. Jesus. Now that we have a little bit better of a idea of what we're supposed to do here, I'm gonna try and pick up that hockey stick again and go with the old Canadian way. If only I could take the gloves off and actually engage in some good old fisticuffs, this fight might not be such a bitch. Brad, you're gonna be there, dude. Need you to not be in the way. And he lines up, he shoots. Nothing. Yeah, see, I mean, it's just so fucking hard to hit. Oh, that worked. And he's gonna shoot. Time for me to shoot. Oh, he doesn't score. Yep. Yep. Damn it. Down to 13 pucks. How many pucks do we give? 12. 11. 10. 8. 7. Oh, so many pucks. So many pucks to be given. Adjust slightly. Wait for it. Ow. Motherfucker. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Don't you dare. Don't you dare be able to kill me right now. All right, I've got two left. And they have Carlito's name written all over it.
Yep.
Oh, that one had window written all over it.
Yep.
Well, fuck. All right. There is another set of hockey pucks or hockey sticks in the mirror. Or in the mirror, in the display there. So I wonder if we can get it. And we get this fucking goddamn it. Probably not without getting horribly murdered. Okay. We need to be able to get to Carlito. Brad, how are you holding up on health? Actually, surprisingly well. And of course, I can't get in the display cage to get anything from inside of it. Great. Otis, I swear to Christ, one of these days I'm gonna come through this fucking walkie-talkie and choke you. Actually, Brad may finish this off for me. If we can just actually shoot him a couple more times, that would be great. You wanna do some work? You wanna do some work, buddy? That would be awesome. Oh, dodge! And, oh, nice! Nice! Oh, come on, Frank! I believe in you! Oh, God, I believe in us. I believe in the power of throwing the katana! Oh, fuck. Drink, 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 drink! Oh! God damn it! We're gonna take a short break. When we come back, there's gonna be a hate story down in Mexico. And Carlito's gonna end up 6 feet under. Don't you dare go anywhere. We'll be right back in just a couple of minutes. We'll be right back.